We're Ulla and Josh, and in December 2022, we sold our house by the sea in Hastings to go in search of a new adventure. Join us as we adjust to living in our new tiny home. We are on our way to pick up our new home. How are you feeling, Josh?
I'm absolutely giddy. I'm excited. I mean, what a perfect day to actually be doing it on. It's so dreamy.
I know, it's absolutely gorgeous. It's a literal winter wonderland outside. Snowy, isn't it?
Look at that, it's magical. Caught me at a moment there, sorry. I feel great. I just feel very tired. It's been a long week.
Long week. I feel very nervous.
Do you actually?
I feel really nervous.
Well, give us a minute and then we'll show you the actual canal.
Yeah.
Because when I saw it, I was buzzing.
We haven't even told you what we're actually moving on to, but I think we've just given it away.
Yeah.
Canal.
Or the title of the video would.
Yeah.
We'll see. This is our new life. Hello, neighbours. What are you up to? No movement. There you are, look.
Hello there.
Just cleaning the windows because our, what are they called? This thing doesn't work.
Our Kersha cleaner. Window sucker upper. It needs charging, doesn't it?
Charging, yeah. And there's actually ice here. There's ice on the inside of the window. Pretty fresh in here. Let's make it toasty. Let's start this baby up, hey?
Yeah, it's absolutely freezing. So obviously, we haven't a clue what's going on. It's basically trial and error at this stage. We haven't been able to learn to light our diesel heater yet. I think there's supposed to be a bit of a knack to it. So
we'll get on to that.
We're going to get the engine running. That's nice and simple.
So we can get some hot water.
Welcome. Oh, hello, world. That's not a bad view to wake up to in the morning, is it?
It's all icy out there.
Excuse my thermals.
I come out too. Oh, bump the head. Gotta get used to that.
Give it 10 seconds.
Is it the glow plugs?
Yeah. I'm gonna skip some rest.
Sounded a bit scary.
I forgot to put the revs on first thing.
We're learning. Oh, steamy. So Josh is cleaning the solar panels, well, clearing them, so that we might get a tiny bit of solar when the sun hits
it. Because
I think we've got barely any battery at the moment.
The leaves are frozen onto it, so I want to keep them clear, you see? Wouldn't be smiling if you were holding frozen leaves in your hands.
I'm bloody freezing, so I'm gonna get some tea.
You look beautiful.
Cheers.
This boat life suits you.
There he is out the window. Very house proud. Still going.
It's thermals.
Hello.
Freezing outside, so I've just come in to warm up my hands. You can hear Josh is still outside cleaning the roof.
Hello.
Hello, back in from being outside.
Oh, thanks, babe. Just to keep it warm.
It's hot.
Ooh.
It was really cold in the kitchen.
Oh, look at it.
Oh, wow.
You never have to drink your hot drink in a rush.
And get cosy next to the fire now.
Okay, sorry, I've got the sniffles.
So we just tried to take a shower, and that was impossible because we've run aground and it's frozen outside. And so when we tried to run the shower, it all pulled out of here onto the floor.
Because of the angle.
Because of the angle we're on. I don't know if you can see, but like the boat is, you can't tell, but we're on a bit of an angle. So that's not a way to sort of warm ourselves up and get clean. So we're going to...
Looking forward to washing my hair and getting all super clean.
Because we haven't quite figured out our diesel heater, which heats our radiators, which is over there. We're going to attempt to light the oven. But it had this ignition kit, which has not been installed. So I think we're just going to do it with a trusty old lighter and warm up this end of the boat.
That's right.
Let's do it, buddy.
Where is the lighter? You said you
I don't know. Got your lighter. Oh. I mean, this should be pretty straightforward.
So, an emergency way of heating the house then. So, bottom one.
Yeah. There we go, some gas, I can hear it. Lovely! Oh, heat! Right, on to the next job. Tool station.
Scriptions.
Which one?
We got a choice. Let's go secure our boat.
Hey, you're right.
Stop the doors from opening because it'll.
Well, let's do. Okay, is that what you think we need? Got what we need, hopefully.
Fingers crossed, my love, yeah.
So what's the time, Josh?
10:30. Well, we did get up early, didn't we? Briefly again.
Yeah, we got up early to try and sort out the fire, because it went out. But it was out again when we woke up, and so today's project is sorting out
the stove,
the diesel stove, because we've got one of these, and we still don't know how to use it.
No.
And we still don't have many of our things, because Josh is drinking tea out of that horrendous mug that we had to buy from the Tesco Express or something.
A lot of people do like China cups. I'm not one of them. I'm not interested. It doesn't make a difference to me, but. It will be nice to have some lovely cups again soon.
It makes a difference to me. That kind of cup doesn't cut it.
Just doing a bit of cleaning.
Sorting out the kitchen.
So we can put our own things away.
Ooh,
great.
Cobwebby. So we've just... We forgot to film this bit, but we've managed to light it with methylated spirits, haven't we? We followed the YouTube tutorial of how to do this.
So, a bit of context. We're the second or third day in now, aren't we? And we haven't managed to master this. So today we've actually took time to watch YouTube videos. We use some methylated spirits, that's going to help. So basically, because it's a diesel system, we want to warm this up in preparation for dripping the fuel into it. So it's a nice warm environment for the diesel. Fingers crossed.
So you can see it's burning nicely at the moment, but that's because of the methylated spirits that are inside. And then after 3 minutes, we apparently turn this little knob back here. And there's that little grey knob down there.
And that's our fuel supply. So that's allowing how much fuel to come in.
Yeah, so we'll turn that on after 3 minutes. And we also need to push a little red knob. A little red knob. That's going to need to be pushed in. And then hopefully it will work, hey?
And we figured out what the little metal bar is. It's called a cleaning needle. So I didn't know whether that was actually the thing that was feeding fuel into it, but we've learnt now that that's a cleaner to clean the pipes out. So
really,
if you're
do
continuously
that.
Going burning, you'll do that every 2 to 3 days just to make sure that the pipes are clear and there's no soot residue that building up into the pipes. You can hear the clinking and the clacking, can't hear if it's warming up.
So it's been 3 minutes and we're gonna turn the knob.
Yeah.
Yeah, you've done that to the one.
Yeah,
and then
resistance.
Push the little red button in, remember?
Yeah.
It should slowly come out by itself. Yeah?
I didn't feel much difference with the red thing, but...
How does it look on the inside?
It's glowing red.
Why? I hope this works.
So do I, because then we can keep warm over this icy winter.
The kettle is boiling on this diesel stove.
Is it?
Yes! Yes, alright!
Finally figuring out how to use this boat!
Yeah, I'm gonna show you. You see that steam? That means it's working! Yes! Excuse me.
What a legend. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're cutting some wood.
Get some kindling together. Oh, it's nice and hot. Thank you.
Mmm. Delicious. Paper plates, because we forgot to bring all of our cutlery. Plates, bowls, saucepans, you name it, we've got it. So this is what we're using. Luckily, I brought one knife with me, my trusty Opinel. Take it everywhere, it's got wax on it, so I might need to give it a clean first. We're gonna have some bread and some yummy nibbles for lunch, some fruit, maybe a bit of pizza.
Yes.
So some pizza, a mini salad,
nice easy stuff that we don't need utensils and cooking facilities for, pots and pans and all that.
Cream cheese, stuffed peppers, and Josh's favourite, Santa Girl.
Yeah, baby.
So it's coming towards the end of the day now and we've just decided to pop out to get ourselves some wood because we're burning through quite a lot of it just to keep ourselves nice and toasty because it's still very cold outside. You can see the water behind us is completely frozen. So we're burning through a lot of wood just to keep warm. So we're going on a little stroll to see what we can find. Let's go. The fire's still going, keeping it cozy inside for us.
I forgot my woolly hat.
You got the key?
Yeah, in my back pocket. I was just looking at that fallen tree in the light. It looks very lovely.
It does, doesn't it? What tree is it?
It's an old oak tree.
Is it?
And there's been a tree surgeon at it. I can see the step cuts on it. Mm-hmm. Let's get some wood. this is the beautiful thing about living where we're living right now on the towpath. You can always find yourself some free fuel, like Ulla's doing right now. She's managed to find herself some good kindling wood. But of course, remember, she's only taking the dead fallen wood. And you're not taking too much of it, are you?
No.
Keeping some from the for the birds and all the insects. It's nice for habitat.
Oh.
Mm.
Right, I think we're good. Yeah, I did.
That was a heron.
It was, wasn't it? That's so cool. Wow. Pretty special, hey?
That was a great moment.
And there's our gorgeous little home. Taking some bits of the car this morning. I feel like it's really cooled down again today. But look at this light on our beautiful floating home. Absolutely gorgeous. You can see it's really cooled down again. It's so frosty. -6 outside. Freezing. What's right there?
Magic. The magic of winter is right there.
After taking some time to breathe in the crisp morning air, we jumped in the car to journey to Milton Keynes to collect some much needed bits from our van that is currently in storage. We spent some time admiring the beautiful British countryside, which was once again covered in a fine layer of snow. Thank you so much for watching our very first vlog. We really hope you enjoyed it and look forward to seeing you again next Sunday for episode 2 of Living on a Narrowboat. Next week on our narrowboat, we get busy tidying to make space for all of our stuff.
We discover water in our engine bay.
We make our first narrowboat dwelling friend.
And find out that we have to make big changes to our upcoming plans of travelling the UK canal and waterways.
In that direction, there is a closure until March.